Mrparka here, reporting from the dungeon, apparently. But I just got done watching the new Ryan Nicholson movie, Famine. This one had a lot of hype, and I really wanted to see it. It had the kind of like the grindhouse trailer, like the students get trapped in the school, and there's a killer, mascot killer going around. So it's definitely a throwback to old 80s slasher films, a la Slaughter High, even Sleepaway Camp, and maybe even a little Fatal Games in there. If anyone's seen it, they might know the references to the last two. But the first one for sure, Slaughter High. These kids want to do this famine, which they haven't done in 5 years. Yes, the students are coming back even after 5 years. That means they're complete morons, and all the characters are complete morons, completely ridiculous and over the top, and don't even seem like a real human being. Some of them seem like they're acting in a Saturday Night Live skit, while others just are so off the wall characters that it's just completely batshit crazy, which makes me think that Ryan Nicholson's characters are never even from this planet. I don't know. They're just out there and weird and over the top and just crazy.
Hey, Kathy. I'm sorry about today. I wasn't talking smack about you. Figures just asked me what happened. What was I supposed to do?
Well, how would you know what happened if you weren't even there?
You're right! Sorry.
Everybody talked about it, but nobody was there. My parents, the cops, doctors, they all talked about it, but nobody was there! And I know I'm right, so back off! Oh, it's just like the rest of us!
I'm not! I am not!
She'll get hers. We're gonna have fun tonight. She's on the list.
We have a list?
It's a saying.
Oh.
You fucking listen to me?
What?
Hurt you. Hey, Donna.
But they come back. They've been repeating the school. They're all morons. They all have an IQ of a pretzel. And they come back to do the famine again. This teacher, this substitute teacher, pushes for it for them to do it. The famine is they get extra credits to stay 24 hours over school without eating anything. Kind of do the whole beat like hunger or live like the people who starved to death. Anyways, what happens is we have a handful of people that something happened in the original famine. A teacher was horribly scarred. That's where Slaughter High comes in. And they're trying to redo the famine, but not have any problems, of course, like last time. Of course, that's not going to happen, and this mascot killer goes around killing people. I was a little disappointed that a couple of the deaths were off-screen, which made me sad, because Ryan Nicholson deaths are always the best deaths. But the death scenes that are on-screen are some of the greatest gore, again. Simple throat slashing is tons of splatter and amazing effects right there. Some of the death scenes aren't super elaborate, they're very simplistic, but the special effects and the gore and the splatter that go with it are amazingly complex, and not complex, but just over the top and awesome. There's a knife to the head, there's a throat slashing, somebody gets acid on them, and that's a great melt thing, a la reminds me of kind of like a Toxic Avenger melt type deal. But I really thought that the gore here was the star of the film. Like I said, the acting and the characters are so weird. It's just like I would explain in Gutterballs, it's like, I don't know if these are the worst actors ever, or just the weirdest characters ever. And that's, again, with Famine. If you're a huge Ryan Nicholson fan, then you gotta see it. I'm really looking forward to Gutterballs, too, because Gutterballs, I think, is his masterpiece. Hanger I thought was pretty good. I think this fall is a little, it's not as good as Hanger, but I know a lot of people have weird feelings about Hanger. It's a weird movie, but I don't think it's as good as Hanger, but I think it's probably better than Bleeding Lady, and it's not as good as Torched either. It's better than Bleeding Lady Live Feed. It falls into there, but I think it's worth a recommendation for splatter fans for sure. If you want to see anytime Ryan Nicholson does special effects, it should be very, very celebrated, I believe. I think that he is probably one of the kings of splatter right at this day and age. I'll show maybe a couple little splatter scenes here and there, but I don't have anything to show you because it's just an online screener. But I would check it out for sure. If you're a Nicholson fan, it's a must. If you're a Splatter fan, it's a must. Like I said, the character's completely weird. A lot of strange things happen. A lot of off-screen deaths. Not a lot. Like 3 or 4. But, again, a couple dozen. About 12 people die or so. So you get some on-screen deaths, some off-screen deaths. Some weirdness, as always. Weird characters, perversion. Only one scene I can think of with actual nudity, which is weird for Nicholson. Because a lot of the stuff in here is usually very pornographic. A la Gutter Balls and Hanger. But, Mrparka, thank you very much for watching. And have a good one.
Did you come to nail someone?
Ouch! 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 Oh, you like to play rough, huh?
I love getting nailed. Nice and hard.
Nail me, baby.
Yeah!